I've gone right back to July when this album released, and we were inseparable. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, Forever Here. I hope that you are all doing well. Newsflash, I am up to date with SB19's activities. I am at their mercy now, them and their schedules. Luckily for us though, it's the anniversary concert this weekend, so early next week I'll be watching some fan cams with you, which I am really excited about, and I'm hoping for some sort of a teaser as to that final part of the trilogy. That should be quite exciting, but no pressure boys, whenever. We're just sat here waiting for that bomb to drop. So today I have dug deep into my playlist, into my Watch Later playlist, and I found a few things that I'm going to watch with you because, yeah, I missed a few things along the way and I definitely want to spend some time watching this stuff. Also, please note that I will not be able to post anything tomorrow because I'm a little bit busy with some other stuff, but vlogs. There are some vlogs coming your way. I'm quite behind actually, and hoping to be able to share that with you slowly in the next couple of weeks. I'm looking forward to sharing everything that I've been up to. And today, right now, I'm going to watch Philippe and his Seven Sins concert in Japan. If you would have a look at the description below, you will see a link to the original fan cams. A huge thank you to 18 that upload this. I'm so excited to watch. And I also found this sound check as well, and I want to hear him sing Moving Closer with this cute hair and this outfit. I'm such a huge fan of this top. I want to own this top. But anywho, how does that sound? Should we spend some time watching Philippe's concert together? I love this outfit. I want to wear this outfit. Don't say that. Please. Oh my gosh. The equipment right here. That is an insane voice. Stop it. I had butterflies. I'm such a cheater. Can you get a little flustered? I cannot get over this talent right here. I mean, we haven't even got into the concert just yet, and I'm like frozen. I don't even know how to feel listening to that. That is, firstly, the equipment right here is amazing. So now I am really excited about watching the concert. But him and that voice and that personality, oh my goodness, that gave me butterflies. That gave me chills. My hair stood up on end. It made my heart flutter. All sorts of things happened to me listening to that. And gosh, his voice is just so full and rich. And it's just so crazy. It's so crazy that whatever happened, happened. And I happen to find an artist like this. I just consider myself to be so lucky. Like, if I gave you a checklist of all the things that I look for in a voice and an artist, like, it's ridiculously Philip. It really, truly is. And I didn't think that that was possible, not in today's age and the way that people are nowadays. I just feel so fortunate to be a fan. Here he comes, stumbling. Oof. Roaring, barking. I can't wait for him to take the hood off. His lyrics just get me. Yes, get the hood off. Mean. You've got to whip that guitar out at some point. Smoking. Was I about to miss this? I can't believe I almost missed this. He is fired up. Off shoulder? Oh my god.
Anybody want some more?
He is fired up. Oh my god, this look. With the off shoulder, like, exquisite. I haven't seen him this hyped up for a very long time. Oh my gosh. I don't know what is going on, but he is so fired up. Every single time I think about him being like incredibly fired up, a few performances pop into my mind at like PeepopCon 2022, I think it was. Was it 2023? I can't really remember. The one where he's got the whole like face mask on, 23. It would have been early 23. And more recently, Billboard PH. Main stage, he was really, really fired up there as well. It's just different. When he starts being like this, it's just so, like, I don't know, you feel like you're backed into a corner. You feel, like, really frightened in the best way. Do really well if you took dancers with him, you know. He doesn't need it, but I think it could work for a lot of his songs. Those boots. Thunderous, just like his voice.
That was fun. Are you guys feeling good, Japan? Good.
So,
first of all, my name is Felipe. And of course, I just want to thank the one of you here for coming.
Yes. His speaking voice.
And of course, this all of them acknowledge there are some Filipinos who flew from Manila. This is here in Japan tonight. So thank you so much. And of course, I saw a lot of the Japanese fans in here.
I'm so happy for him that this happened.
Of course, from Indonesia, and from Russia right there, thank you so much for coming, and of course, my name is Jeremy. That's crazy. Oh, but that wasn't the name of Singapore, right? The people of Singapore. This is Singapore from here in Japan. Thank you so much for coming. And yeah. That was really exciting. You guys enjoyed that one? Yeah! And you guys enjoyed that one?
Yeah! What if you're going to ask me like that?
I'm the type of artist now. I don't want my performance to be not Patagal, so I'm just going to go right ahead.
Do it.
Patagal, you go on.
Does he perform Palayo?
Yeah. I'm saying that I'm going to perform my next song right now. I'm gonna get my Mic stand, please. So my song was Frozen Envy. So I just released my album last month, I think, yeah. Oh, July 5. I released my album July 5. So I hope you enjoy your album, go. And of course, I'm not going to enjoy your album, go, but I hope you enjoy your own one. Alright. I'm sorry guys if I'm speaking to you now. But I'll try my best to speak English and of course Japanese if I can. Of course, I don't forget to, you know, to greet all my Japanese fans. Konnichiwa! I'm sorry if I missed that, but yeah, I hope you understand. I love you guys so much. Japanese fans, thanks to you. I still. So yeah, the next song is called Greed as well.
Greed,
doctor.
Greed.
No.
You guys ready for this one?
Let's go sing your heart out. Actually, the hood works really nicely for this song. Oh. His voice just like reverberates all through your body. Favorite R&B runs. Let's go. He is the definition of an artist that could release a live album. I mean, if we were to put this and the official track side by side, there is barely any difference. Actually, his voice is even deeper when he's performing live. That's just some really, like, it messes with your mind, right? It's a real, like, I honestly don't know what's going on. I keep feeling like I'm going into a trance. I'm like, is this really real? Like, why is this man's voice, like, traveling through my body? Like, what is going on? I'm just watching a video of it. It's just so insane. Like, listening to him, watching a performance of his, it's just such an experience. And I can't even imagine what it would be like if he were there in real life. Like, even for me right here, I am just so certain that this man is out of this freaking world. Like, there's no trickery here. There's no effects. There's nothing. It's just him in his little hoodie on this stage. Like, there's nothing going on this stage. There's barely even any, like, a hint of lighting or anything, right? It's just him, his voice, and a microphone. Like, oh. Where is the rest of the world? Because the world seems to go on and on about true talent, and they seem to moan about people that are I don't know, like, created or, like, artificially made up to be the way they are, and they don't sing live and they don't make good music. Where are these people when there is a man right here in front of us that is like this, of this caliber? To July when this album released, and we were inseparable. Oh. I don't want it to end. Can it just loop? Oh, he's really just going for it. Like, there's barely any breaks. It's like two songs. This song gives me a complex feel. Marilyn, where are you? I just love it. I'm going to change my name to Marilyn. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Marilyn here. How does that work? Zena performed Gluttony or not? All you can see is this part of him, and it's so stunning. To collab with Mo of Alamat. The magic that the two of them will create. Ooh. No.
You did? Okay, make it louder for us. Give it louder. That was sorry, but of course, guys, I really love you so much. For cheering me up. And I'm on pretty safe. Thank you so much for cheering me up. And of course,
I hope you like
us. Those that grieve, and of course, cry. If I get anything out of you, bro.
Yeah!
That's good, right? That's good. So, I'm gonna get right into my next performance, my next song.
Take your time.
Okay.
The supportive comment from 18. I love you guys so much. Look, my eyes are tearing up talking about 18. I adore 18.
My new friends, thank you so much for coming. And of course, Warner Japan, thank you so much. Warner Philippines, thank you so much for supporting me. And of course, don't forget, X-Fans for coming here. My beautiful people, CZ, AC, thank you so much for coming. Thank you, Japan. Thank you, my fans, for joining the camera. And of course, my new Japanese fans right here. And the fan also, thank you so much for coming. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for coming. And I learned so much Japanese words, you know that?
Tell us.
That's right. Ikimen from the Philippines, thank you so much for inviting me here, and of course, and of course, Crazy Man from my producer, and of course, thank you so much. Yeah. So this is my next song. This one's called Run. Let's go.
Look at his like incredibly beautifully baby face, and then he's got these really manly hands, all these veins. I can't wait to hear Ake in this place. No, not the hood again. I felt that in my shoulders. This is Ken. I bought these chains. You know those chains he wears on his jeans? It's very Y2K. I used to have them. I got some. Basically, I just want to be Ken. That's actually really true. I giggled, but it was true. It's such a roary song. To be fair, I think this could also be on Complex, and I wouldn't bat an eyelid. I'd be like, okay. I like it. I feel like it's like some sort of continuity from Complex to Seven Sins. and for sure goes to show that he does have his own style. Backflip. Because I think the effects are switched on to his mic, but I don't know, like, I just can't feel them, I can't hear them that well. It sounds like his voice.
So, I made a song with my friend. This is the last song for the album. It's exclusively released in Japan.
Any excuse to hear this again? I just can't figure that voice out, especially when you get a good look at his throat and everything. I just don't get how he produces this sound. It's so different. So I wonder if it's actually possible for me to listen to this in any way. Like, is this on YouTube? I'm really, sadly, unfamiliar with this. Let's see. I can listen to a live version of it. I want, like, the proper track. Tokyo. Not quite. That's really interesting, you know. Do you want to hear about my Seven Sins album drama? It's really not very exciting. I have not received my album. First it got lost, and then I don't know what happened with the second one. I guess it got lost again.
But I hope you guys enjoy that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, what were you tape? Did you guys get a tape?
Yeah.
Did you know? How was it? Was it good? Good. Me and some Sanyo! That's good. And of course,
you can see some of the, like, shyness creep into his face when he, like, does stuff like that.
And finally, for the first time.
Aww. Bigger stages for Philippe in Japan.
It's what I was praying for. It's what I was hoping for. So in the future, when we are
teach him more.
Of course,
The food here is so good.
Yeah.
Food here is so good.
Ramen.
It's an aqua ramen, bro.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, that's an aqua ramen. But I really love to put something here today. So,
yeah.
Oh yeah, the first time I was here in Japan, I bought like 5 nigiri. I really love nigiri so much. I just put it in the bag and just like brought it with me everywhere.
They have the
coffee machine. The coffee machine, because we don't have it in the Philippines, you know. So yeah, I really like it. I really like Japan. Everything is like very convenient for me, you know.
You just fit.
So yeah, it's like, I really love it here. And of course, I can buy a lot of manga.
Yeah.
I can read it. I can watch anime. It's like, this place is like literally anime for me. It's like my dream place. Oh yeah, but someone said that. Yeah.
I like this little talking section. This is so cute. You can end the show. Excuse me, what, sir? Absolutely not, you liar. But, I really like that he thought about what he wanted to say, like, suited to the destination, right? Sing them all. Sing Complex. And sing all of the additional songs. Paleo.
So I release more songs. Yeah. Can I release more songs?
Yeah.
And should I release more songs? Yeah. Okay, next year.
Let me just put that into my diary. What's wrong with that?
More.
Soon. So I'll do that soon. But yeah, before I end my show.
Faker, you liar.
Let's see. Before I end my show. Before I end my show. No, I feel sad also that I'm doing my show today. Because that's the reality, right? But always remember that I love you guys so much. Thank you for coming here. Thank you so much. But yeah, I would like to thank Warner Music Japan, Toyo Home Productions, Warner Music Philippines, Video Money Right There, Team Philippe, 1032 Lab, Luis Icy Island for being here, and of course Spotify for the support. And all of this for being here to my friends, Philip Stans, 18, Cecil, 18 Japan, and of course my Japanese fans in here. Thank you so much for coming. And I hope that you guys stay safe always. And yeah, thank you, beloved. Take care always. And of course, it's Sky High for coming here, for watching the show. Thank you so much, bro, for coming. And yeah.
What's next? Which is?
Okay, can I ask you, Lisa, come up on stage? You know, will you be up now? Sorry. Hey, Luis, can you come up on stage? Hey, you guys are pretty good! Where's Luis? Hey, Luis.
Oh my god, if my name was Louise, I would have edited the absolute crap out of that to suit me. What is it?
This one, they say, yeah. I would really treasure this one. Thank you so much. I would cherish this one. It wasn't my life.
Oh, is it all signed from everyone? That's super cute.
I love you guys so much.
That's so cute.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Here's somebody that knows the importance of taking more than one selfie in case someone blinks, you know?
That's right. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
We love you.
Thank you so much. Can we get into the next song? You know what? I've been taking a lot of pictures, and you know, my manager's phone also, there's a lot of pictures of you guys outside. And yeah, literally, you guys are in my camera raw.
I've never seen him be like this before. This is really, really different. You can tell how happy he is only when he feels really happy, and like when he feels like he's achieved something and he really wants to express everything that's going through his mind and his heart is when he gets chatty like this. You can almost feel that he doesn't quite want to move on to the next song. Oh, this man, he is so special. It's really endearing.
It's not you, it's you and God. No, it's not about you. It's not about you.
No outfit changes.
I close on the wall. The memories we call. No, if it's not about you. If it's not about you. You're in the kind of
I know where this song leads to. I really love that when he does that. What I've noticed about him is obviously I did marathon through all of his solo performances wherever he went to perform Complex. I watched it all, and I noticed like in those days there were points where he started to get a little bit tired or his voice did, because his schedule was just so incredibly relentless. And I wouldn't say that their schedules have changed very much since then, to be honest. It's probably got a lot worse, but I think that he is really looking after himself now, looking after his voice. He knows that he wants to do this in the long run, and obviously we've heard him talk about his fear of losing his voice, not being able to sing again. We know just how much this means to him. So I think that I've noticed that the quality of his voice is getting better. His voice is getting stronger, if that's even freaking possible. And I just really love to hear it. Like, look at him. He's been singing, chatting, everything for like 33 minutes so far. And I just feel like his voice is in a really good place. The sound system in this place is sick. I wanted to get on his knees. Oh, Sloth. That was amazing. That was honestly amazing. Oh gosh, we're going straight into it. A song. I'm so looking forward to this. Quality of this man's voice, oh my gosh. When I first heard him sing Moving Closer in that sound check, this is what I was looking forward to, and I am not disappointed. His voice is so monstrous, isn't it? Listen to that again. This song is so incredibly moving, and I always think about him and his voice being in one of those mall tours and people that have never heard him before walking past and turning around. Is that kind of a voice? You would just have to find out whose voice that is. That is not an everyday occurrence. Nobody has a voice like this, and especially like when you look at mainstream music, very few artists have heavy voices like this. I think that people tend to like that kind of like middle ground. They like people that can reach low notes and can reach high notes, but they really like that kind of middle okay? And for me personally, that can get quite repetitive and quite boring. I do like to look for something else. You know, this morning I was listening to Pablo's albums and I was listening to Latin and I was just like, gosh, this is just so different. And it just really, really blows my mind that these five men are part of one group. Like, I don't know how to explain it. It's not fate. It's not even meant to be. I just think the whole idea of SB19 finding each other to be completely wild. To be quite honest with you, it's wild that they ended up in this one group and that one thing led to another and they've all been releasing their solo music and it happens to be of the standard that it is. Because I was listening to Tambol and I was like, what is this? I was like, I don't like it, but I do like it. It challenges my ear. It's not a song type that I'm used to listening to. But why is it that I can't get enough of it? Like, they just push the boundaries of music, and the same thing can be applied to each and every single member of SB19. And Philippe, I mean, I say so much about him, and I can't say enough, apparently. He's just so unique in his sound, and for me personally, when I'm searching for somebody, I do really like to listen to those deep voices. You know, even when I... back in like school and university, or if an advert plays, for instance, if it's, I notice it, I'm really conscious of the fact that if it's a deep, engaging voice, you have my attention. I'm sold. Whatever it is that you're selling, I'm sold. There's something, there's a pull within me. I don't know what it is about that depth, but I just feel so lucky that here is an artist that has everything. And then he happens to be so humble and so cutesy, and he's not 2D, you know, he is so much more than his voice as well. And did I rewind it? In the middle of egg? That makes me want to cry.
Can you sing this one for me?
I just imagine this song being performed on like those big, massive stages with like a massive choir, and oh, it would just be so incredibly special. Can you imagine like a stadium roaring this song? Does he come back? Oh, this is a surprise. This is like the best concert ever. Japan is so lucky. This would be a good time to slip off that shoulder, Ken. And they're just so perfect. I just know Complex deserve to be out there to have these different stops. I don't ever want to forget about Complex. That mood he was getting into, oh my gosh, that was quite hot. Oh, you just would not want him to leave. Please stay. Yeah. Just do it, 18. Just perform it anyway. That's a good venue. I bet he's got the biggest smile backstage. Super cute. This is so fun. He came back. Was that supposed to happen? Oh, this is so cute. No in ears, just having fun. Oh. Oh, I can just feel how happy he is. He suddenly transformed into my baby. I don't understand what happened. Just a second ago, I was like, this was really hot. And now, this is my child. This is effed up. That's like the first proper look we've got in his face, because the lights are up a bit more. Enjoy it. I feel like this wasn't planned. Like, I didn't think that was the end. And I don't think that he was supposed to come back for this, really. He just couldn't resist. Look how happy he is. Where are we going now? Oh! Look at him getting all shy. He looks so beautiful in red hair. Red is for sure his colour. It suits his features, his personality, the depth of his skin. And makeup wise, he's not too done up either. Oh my gosh, he's so beautiful! Kenny! I thought you weren't supposed to hug him. Like, they're hugging him. I swear that wasn't allowed. This must be a different kind of ticket. I think I'm really going to feel some concert blues after watching this, because seeing him that happy is just giving me so much energy. Is that really weird? I'm taking energy from this. I feel so hyped up watching this. I feel really good. I feel like I'm in such a good mood because I saw him smile. His little like cheeks, when they get like proper up, that means he's genuinely like super happy, energetic. And this was so good. He was so hyped in this. His voice was in such good quality, and like, he didn't need anything. He didn't need any sort of like major lighting switches, no like major stuff on the screen behind him, no outfit changes, nothing, just him and that monstrous voice. Like, I can't get to grips with that, and I'm looking forward to that more music that he's planning on releasing next year. I hope that he'll maybe attempt more R&B stuff, more ballads. Maybe the ballads will have more like higher sections in them, because like that voice, his falsetto, his higher range is also so gorgeous. It'd be really nice to hear some of that in his songs. And this was just so much fun, and I really love this bonus in the end where we got to like look around a little bit of the venue, and then we got to see him and that whole photo op as well. That was just so much fun. I'm just so happy that this happened for him. So many great things have happened for him this year, and I hope that the year ends on a massive high for him as well. And yes, let's just keep going. I mean, yeah, if this is his dream, then I wish him more and more success in Japan. But I just do want to say, not from like a selfish point of view, but I can put some good money on it that he will be really loved in London. I think people love an artist like that. And especially when they get to see his personality as well. I can see him playing similar sorts of venues here. And really, I'm thinking like, if SB19 were to come here for a concert, then for sure, the boys, when they want to and able to, they should also look for solo opportunities, because let's not just come over here and have SB19 concerts. Let's do a Philippe concert and a JC concert, and let's do it all. Why not, eh? If you're going to come all the way, then Stel, you might as well marry me. All I had to do was get through this one video without mentioning that man, and I couldn't, could I? It's a disease. Anyway, please talk to me about this concert. I cannot wait to hear what you have to say, and I'm just, my heart is full right now. I might have run out of SB19 stuff to watch, but right now I feel so good. I feel not even the slightest bit worried. Thank you so much for watching this with me. I hope that you had fun, and until I see you next time, take care. Stay safe. Bye.